This is BBC One. Now it's time for Election 87 Breakfast Special with Frank Boff, Sally Magnusson and Jeremy Paxman.
Good morning to you. Welcome to Election 87 Breakfast Special. And the news, if you're just waking up this morning, is that Mrs. Thatcher is back for a record third term as Prime Minister. Her majority reduced, but still a conclusive triumph. Labour failed to make a significant impact on the Tories, although they made gains in the North and Scotland. For the Alliance, it was a night of disaster. Roy Jenkins being ousted in Glasgow Hillhead, Shirley Williams failed to win Cambridge. The state of the parties at the moment, as you wake and join us this morning, is as follows. Conservatives, this is after 595 results so far. Conservative seats, 348. Labour, 225. Alliance, 16. And others, only 6. So Conservative losses there, 15. And there we have the BBC's projected forecast of a Conservative majority of Mrs. Thatcher in the new Parliament of 104 seats. Good morning, Sally.
Good morning. In today's programme, we'll be examining what the result means for the main political parties and their leaders. Mrs. Thatcher's in 10 Downing Street again. Will she, as she once said, go on and on? Neil Kinnock's at his home in Ealing, defeated even though Labour fought its best campaign in years. David Owen is at a hotel in his constituency at Plymouth, his party decimated. And at Ettrick Bridge, David Steele, who must be now considering the future of the Alliance.
Well, Peter Snow has been playing the keys of his battleground piano all night and will continue to do so for us this morning. Give us another tinkle, Peter. Good morning.
Yes, Frank. Well, this is where we watched the battle being fought overnight. And these are the crucial seats Mrs. Thatcher had to defend, in which we've seen the battle being lost by the opposition, because they had to turn these seats red and gold, and it's a measure of the Alliance's and Labour's failure that this is all they've managed to do. Look at all the blue on our battleground. That's Mrs. Thatcher's success.
Well, we have a full-strength team out this morning. Our third member, Jeremy Paxman, is over the far side of the studio. He's going to be looking after our guests this morning. So let's hear a little from him at this stage. Good morning.
Thanks, Frank. Yes, well, we have a series of guests, of course, throughout the morning. My first three guests are three new boys to the House of Commons. Ken Livingstone, the former leader of the GLC, who'll be taking his seat for the first time for Labour. Andrew Mitchell, who's a new Conservative MP, and Menzies Campbell, who's a new Alliance MP, one of the only two they've got.
Well, the fact is that overnight, the opinion polls have been proved right. It's been a night of victory for the Conservatives, deep gloom indeed for Labour, and grief for the Alliance, as Mrs. Thatcher was returned to number 10 with a substantial majority. And so, from that main story of the night, let's turn to Peter Snow again for a more detailed analysis of the overnight picture that is now emerging.
Well, Frank, here's the story of Mrs. Thatcher's success and Labour's and the Alliance's failure. Here we have the map building up. Now we have results, 595 of the 650 results now in, just about 55 to come today. 348 Conservatives, watch the map, building up there. Of course, Labour has more seats than it appears because they have the main conurbations there. They have lots of seats in the city centres. The Conservatives control the countryside. 16 for the Alliance so far and 6 others. Let's just put in the winning post. They have to get through 326. One party has to get through that to win. There's Mrs. Thatcher, forecast on 377, just 20-odd seats less than she had last time. The Labour Party on 229, the others on 24, with the Alliance just on 20, 7 down on what they were in the last Parliament, a Conservative majority of 104. Let's go inside the chamber of the new House of Commons and have a look at what it's going to look like with the new lineup. There's Mrs. Thatcher, there's the winning post, she's through it, 377, Mr. Kinnock on the opposition benches, there they go, 229 Labour, lots of little other parties building up, the Alliance, the Scottish Nationalists, the Plaid Cymru's, 273, separate one from the other and you get a Conservative majority, Frank, of 104.
I must say, your enthusiasm for the job in hand remains undiminished after a long night. Well now then, since the other programme went off the air at 4 o'clock, another result has come in at York. And